Hear me, whatever that God is not doing, I have vowed not to attach my emotion to it. Why we get so broken is because we attach our emotions to what devil is wrestling in our lives. I opened my mouth, I said, I've gone too far. God has done so many things that I can count them. Like the songwriter said, count your blessings. Amen. We don't pay attention when we are singing. If you're a lawyer, you can't go to defend anybody without facts, right? Every testimony, every goodness of the Lord in your life, in the past and in the present, they're your tools. But often we get so selfish, so greedy, so self-absorbed, that all of those things mean nothing to us. And we feel so hurt, people that we once blessed and encouraged, when they turn their backs at us and forget us, we feel so bitter. What do you expect of God? Of course, He is God. Let's forget Him, right? But when the young woman chose, you turn to Him. There's no such relationship that it works. There are men that forget the days that their wives labored with them, and they have come to a place of greatness. They are like the average church member that God helped. But in a moment of his difficulty, he would not turn back again to count on those different premises that God proved himself. Some will even want to blackmail God. God, are you there? Did you drive him? Are you on the throne? Did you dethrone him? Say, why me? Why not you? With all that he has done for you, he expects you to stir. I have done so much for God. Yes, Ephesians said, after having done all, you said what? Stand. Not quit. James would have fooled us when he said in chapter 1 verse 2, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. I would have said, shut up, James. But he was talking from the angle of the goodness of the Lord serving as a premise of defending the gospel and taking what belongs to you from the hand of the devil. If you are seated here and God has ever blessed you once, you will get to whatever sins in life that you wish. I'm telling you the truth. Yes. Apostle Paul understood this clearly. He had the nine gifts and he could say, I wanted to come, but Satan hindered me. He had so much opposition. Just imagine you are doing something for the Lord, like going to reach out to be a blessing, and then you are arrested in the midst of preaching the gospel or sharing tracts or inviting somebody to church, and then they said your punishment requires, 40 strokes of the cane. But we will discount one. So give him 39. We are nice people. Now he suffered that 3 times. If any person in Nigeria is beaten 3 times, 39 strokes of the cane at different occasions, you will quickly change from evangelist or pastor to a musician. You will conclude that maybe I didn't hear very well. And that's what happened to us. When we are passing through difficult times, we begin to check whether our calling is of God. Or you will begin to think, whether would God answer me? 3 occasions. In 1 occasion, it was road, not Koboko. They gave it to him, but the man will not stop. They threw him into the prison, and he wrote more than half of the New Testament in the prison. Why? God has shown mercy to you. God has saved you. God has proved himself. And he made one statement. He said, those that have enjoyed the power of the world to come, if they look back, they start backsliding or becoming cold. It's difficult to win them back. And that's why we have old Christians are the problem of the church today. If you wake up with your fire, they say, we were there. Yes. So what are you saying? They know it all. No impact. I want you to leave this convention a better woman. So that you can square up your shoulder and face what has been facing you that wants to take away your confidence. You think another person that is not passing through, the worst thing that you are passing through is a better Christian. It's a lie. It's a lie. This is how to stay anointed above your failures. I have so much to say to encourage you. Because I want you to go back and pick those old battles again. Yes, sir. Where you gave up, you are the winner there. Amen. Where they mocked you, you have despised them, you are returning. Yes. The Bible says, and the 70 return. And the Bible says, therefore the redeem of the Lord shall return unto Zion. Yes. And that returning became the returning of their testimony. They returned with everlasting song. They left with sorrow and they were returned with joy. Gladness shall be over their heads. And that's what God is setting. All these women stand before me. That where you were mocked, God will pick you up and elevate you. If you thought that mess or that setback or that disappointment was the end of your heart desire, no. God is coming big for you. No matter who has become a deviant around you that has vowed that you would see good days ahead of you, I'm here to tell you that that person is not God. That Jehovah that created you has better future for you. He's not towards you and not out of evil, though you're passing through difficult times. Your testimonies are for defending because of you. Now finally, so that I can allow you to do other useful things here today. You know, Jesus made a statement. He was born from Bethlehem of Judea, Nazareth, but did not live there. He went to Capernaum and pitched his ministry headquarters there for several reasons. He lived all his life there. Some of you, this is your January.